All right, guys. So these just came in the mail. Dual cone intakes. I ordered a bunch of other stuff on here, but that's gonna go into here. So give it a couple seconds and.
I keep my gun in my drawers, ducking the sad news. My phone say 7 missed calls, I know it's bad news. This life had left me so scarred, I'm knowing that's true. Remember time got so hard, I got it tattooed. I painted no shows, but made some bread. I gotta keep the family fed. Look, just talk to Pops about the feds. I ain't gonna lie, he had me scared. I feel him coming.
Alright guys, so I just finished up the install. I pulled out that whole air box, the stock one, huge, weighs a shit ton compared to these little things. And plus it's just a supporting mod. This isn't a, like, it is a performance mod, but it's not like a major one. You won't notice like significant horsepower gains from this. I also bought a, I bought the JB4. So that's going to increase horsepower along with that as well. As installing a charge pipe, just so the OEM one doesn't blow. Charge pipe doesn't add any horsepower, but I did choose one with a teal blow-off valve. So this is not going to bring a lot of horsepower. The JB4 is going to bring the most horsepower. This helps the JB4 bring horsepower, and so does an intercooler. The downpipe is only so that you don't blow up your downpipe and lose boost while you're on the freeway or something, because the stock one is plastic. It's known to blow, very known to blow if you drive an N54. Super common. They blow once you start putting the turbo up. Even if you don't put the turbo up, sometimes they go. So if you start putting turbo up, expect it to go eventually. If it doesn't fast, it will eventually. So I ordered a charge pipe and yeah, these guys, intercooler, JB4. So yeah, basically FBO, basically full bolt-on. Just need an exhaust system, but yeah, basically full bolt-on right here. This is not full bolt-on yet. This is the first bolt-on, obviously not full bolt-on yet. This is the smallest of packages. But it's the first one they got here, so it's the first one to go on. I'm gonna fire the car up and see what happens, if it smokes, if it catches on fire, what the hell. Yeah guys, that's it for the dual cone, whatever the fuck it's called, dual air intake install. I hope you guys liked it. It was really easy. It took me 5 minutes to take out the air box, another 5 minutes to put them in. Putting them in at first is a little tricky because you have the alternator there and then the intake manifold there too. So the intake manifold kind of like it blocks the bottom of the rear intake. So I had to put that one in first so I can get it in right. And then once I had that one in right, I put in the metal piece to the front one. And then once I had the metal piece into the front one, all nice and tied in, I had the rear one in fully, cone and pipe. And then the front one, I had just the pipe in. And then I installed the cone, and that's how I got them both in. So I had to start off with the rear, move on to the pipe in the front, and then the cone. And yeah, I got it installed and clamped on, and it runs perfectly fine, like a champ. Now I just gotta wait for the rest of the bolt-ons, because this isn't gonna do shit for me, obviously. It's actually the next day. And I'm waiting for FedEx to bring me another package. So it already set out for delivery. I'm just waiting for that. And that'll be the next one. That'll be the charge pipe and blow off valve. So thank you guys for watching. And as always, if you guys liked it, please leave a like. Subscribe if you can. I really appreciate it. You don't have to, but just leave a like, please. Truly do appreciate that one. And enjoy your day, guys. If you're watching this in the weekend, well, enjoy your weekend. If it's a weekday, we'll just get through it and the weekend's coming.